I thought it was a really, really fascinating day. If a little information overload, it's always tough to listen to talks for a full day, no matter, and even when they're so fascinating, but also very challenging to understand some of the concepts and the real issues that are involved. So just like to say a few words before we wrap up and go for a drink. So every year, Predict has become a barometer, taking the temperature of incremental changes in the way AI and analytics is impacting society and being embraced by business. One of the big challenges apparent at this year's event, to me, is how the technologies we have been talking about for years are moving out of the laboratory and how it's now talked about in the light of real-world applications. Today, there was a lot of talk about use cases. There was ambitious projects. There was people talking about building robots that could be generally useful for under $1,000. There was people talking about artificial generalized intelligence as if that was something that's a trivial, achievable technical task. There was talk about use cases in the home, in healthcare, in food, in supply chain, and sustainability. Important topics. Ben Duffy talked about the artificial generalized intelligence, and he alluded to robotics companies that had gone bust. And they need to think differently and reimagine how robotics are affordable, useful, and robust. We've built robots that can do things, but they're too expensive. And Ben, with his bootstrapping and his not-for-profit, is trying to build something very ambitious. So it's really exciting to see that type of ambition and engagement with technology and AI happening right here in Ireland. When Constant Breedon talked about data science, he stressed the importance of having models that are sustainable and cost-effective, of machine learning models that are successful. Eric Risser talked about the evolution of creative AI and how it could save money for the billion-dollar games industry. We saw the creative AI in the art exhibition today and in between the talks. And it's quite incredible how they do these things, the code-generated art that I've never seen before. It was amazing to see that here this year. On the Yellow stage, they explored predictive maintenance and multi-spectral imaging to improve the quality of grass for farming. Diverse and real applications in the real world in farming and in agriculture of AI at work. Conor McGinn and Alessandro Pascal showed how caring robots and personalized AI can address some of the biggest challenges in the world about healthcare and an aging population. And I was fascinated to hear Conor's talk on how when the robots started to screw up or couldn't articulate the words or ran out of power, that the people didn't respond harshly because they were encouraging the robot. They were trying to say, come on, you can do it, which I understood to be the opposite. People expect technology to work, and if it doesn't work first time in the right way, they can get very frustrated. So it's interesting to see the dynamic of his technology and how it manifests, and people are actually empathizing with the robot and encouraging it. And he's trying to get his technicians and his researchers to understand that. And that's a really interesting dynamic between technology, psychology, and product management even. We saw an amazing talk on product management here from Intercom. I really liked the 1 week prototyping, the 1 month, get this out the door, you know, show it to people, get feedback, don't make it scalable, just get it working. Understand if it's going in the right direction. And then the crunch where it's like, oh, that's pretty good. Not good enough, but I know he can make it work. And he's like, oh, how do I make this work? So it's very impressive that he actually got it out the door in a company like Intercom, which has 30,000 customers, and you can't mess around with that at that level of scale. So this afternoon, we heard about the role of data analytics in some of the biggest battles we face around sustainability, climate change, and city planning. Robert Ross, in one of the CEDAR sessions, talked about data science using AI for the forces of good. In the final session, we learned a little bit more about, you know, the real business value that it is delivering in customer centers, in churn prediction, in lifetime value. For real businesses, it's proving its value day in, day out. There was something, I hope, for everyone in the audience. As we always do, we had speakers to check ourselves to remind us that the execution of analytics projects is complicated. John Elder explained in his eloquent way how models are flawed and humans are even more flawed when it comes to bias in their interpretation of models and data. and how we can be misled. So, and there was words of caution. We talked about the danger of bias. Susan Levy, in particular, was talking about the danger of bias and gender bias and how we can actually see that clearly from the data, from the Guardian newspaper, from historical fiction novels, and how it hasn't even changed in the way that people are talking. And that's dangerous. And we all know that we used to talk about garbage in, garbage out in models in such that bad data in makes bad results. But now we have got good data, but is it the right data? Is it biased? So it's now bias in, bias out is the key risk for modelers. How the future is focused on technology and delivering outputs that threaten to do some of the hard-earned, you know, wins and legislation from the past. And that's the challenge with the power of these models. They can undo some of the good things that we take for granted in society. And how we find ourselves using language about gender that is no better than the 19th century fiction. So, frightening stuff and a stark reminder about the power and the opportunity in technology and AI, but also checking ourselves and reminding ourselves to be careful. But again, plenty to think about. So finally, I just want to say thank you to all of you who have managed to stay for the day. I really appreciate your engagement. Thank you to our speakers, who I thought this year were even exceeded all of my expectations, were absolutely excellent. Thank you to the volunteers. Thank you to the moderators, the partners. Let me get the partners up, without whom this event wouldn't happen, of course. Thank you to the RDS, who are like a partner to us these days. Thank you to the caterers and the AV guys, who are incredibly great, just looked after us so well. And thank you again to all of you for your engagement and support. So, please join us for a drink. It's not in the experience zone. We're actually moving across the road to the horse show house. So please feel free to make your way across the road and join us for a complimentary drink on us. So thank you very much, and that's a wrap for this year.